TMS Web Core now offers drag and drop support for visual controls. Let's look at the drag and drop support in detail. As many other web frameworks or frameworks in general, TMS Web Core highly benefits from object-oriented programming. All visual controls are derived from the same class. That means drag and drop is available now for most visual controls using the same events. If you write TMS Web Core controls yourself, you just have to publish certain properties and override a few methods. Very similar to the VCL and FireMonkey, four events are being used for drag and drop. On start drag is triggered when a drag operation starts. The counterpart is on end drag, when a drag operation ends. The on drag over event allows you to find out if a certain control is hovering above your control during a drag operation. On drag drop, finally, is triggered when a drop happens on a control during a drag operation. But enough with the theory, let's go into Delphi and look into one of the examples that's bundled with TMS Web Core. In the basics folder of the demo projects for Web Core, you find the drag and drop project. The first thing you have to realize is that there is no specific drag and drop component that you need to drop on your phone to enable the functionality. The whole functionality is now embedded using events in existing controls that you've known in previous versions of TMS Web Core. For example, looking at the T-Web string grid, looking at the events, opening up the object inspector, and then here we find on and drag, and of course the counterpart on start drag. So these events have to be implemented if you want to find out when a drag operation starts and when a drag operation ends. However, what we're more interested in is if something is dragging over, hovering over the control, or if a control is dropped on the control that we have selected right now. So in this case, for this string grid, on drag drop implements the functionality what is supposed to happen if a control is dropped on this very string grid. On drag over is triggered when something is hovering over the grid, but the user has not released the left mouse button yet, so it's still hovering on top of it and gives you the opportunity to maybe deny that the user can drop the certain object that is being held right now inside of the drag operation. You can find the same events for all the controls that are shown on this form. Here is a T-Web page control, and again, drag drop and drag over are implemented, but in this case, there's also an implementation for on start drag. So looking at the application running inside of the web browser, you see that you have normal tab controls with controls embedded on the tabs. And of course, you have string grids that have default values inside. And if you, for example, select cell 24 and drag it, you can see that the drag operation is animated inside of the browser. And here you see that the operation is invalid, indicated by the no parking sign. And then when you move it over here, it's still not valid. But as soon as you hover over a cell, you can drop it. So let's overwrite cell 44 with cell 24, and you see that it is also removed from the other string grid. But this demo does not only show you how you can drag information between controls of the same kind. For example, you can drag the content of cell 33 to this list item right here. And you see that the cell 33 has been added to the list. To make things even more interesting, you can drag tabs between different page controls. So here you see left 1, left 2, left 3, and another page control with three tabs on the right. Let's drag left 2 over to the right. And there you see that even the controls that are hosted inside of the tab panel are copied as well. This is because of the owner principles between control and parent control that we have all gotten so accustomed to from the VCL. Let's look at the implementation of the drag and drop operation for the page control. First, let's look at the hover operation, meaning drag over. The associated event is web page control 1 drag over. Just like in the VCL, we get the X and Y coordinates of the current position of the mouse cursor, you get a drag state, and you have the option to deny the drag by setting accept to false. In this case, accept is set with a Boolean expression. First of all, we check that the source of the drag operation is also a TWeb page control. And finally, we check that the source is different from the sender, meaning it is really another TWeb page control. The second event, the drag drop event, really has to do the modification of the control, meaning it has to move over the tab sheet from the one page control to the other. Let's focus on the drag and drop related specific implementation. TMS is extra careful here with this implementation, checking again that the sender is not equal to the source. Then we can cast directly to TWeb page control because we are certain that it is a TWeb page control because our drag operation would not be accepted if it wouldn't be a TWeb page control. We call begin update and end update to make sure that the page control is only redrawn, or actually both page controls are only be redrawn, when all the modifications have been made. We then create a new web tab sheet instance and add all the controls from the originating tab sheet to this sheet using its parent property. You can see this in the for loop, where the parent component of each control inside of the old sheet is set to the new sheet. And finally, we release the old sheet from memory using sheet.free. Once again, TMS uses well-known concepts from the VCL to bring you over to the web with TMS Web Core. Drag and drop operations are available using events that you have become used to years ago.